Hey guys, I know a lot of you have questions on exactly how to use this template for your IG Live. I know a lot of you have already tested it, tried it out, but maybe you were doing a dual IG Live, so your template moved a little, or you have questions. I'm here to walk you through the exact process, so let's get started. All right, so I'm here on the exact link that you receive once you fill out the form. It's completely free, as you guys know, and this opens up. So Canva is an application that if you don't already have it, you can use it on your phone or on your computer, whatever you want. It has the same exact functions. I personally like the computer just because I'm more familiar with it on the computer and I have more availability to move the mouse and to edit it quicker. So that's just how I do it. All right, so you're on this page, you're going to use the template. If you don't already have a free Canva account, it might ask you to create an account or you can just use it like that, but it's super simple, just log in. So on the first page, I have a welcome note for you guys. It just says that this is a template and if you have any questions, like you know, you can follow us on TDC or my personal Instagram, Laura Gomez, all right? So on page 2 is the first example of a template that we have. So let me explain a little of what I did so you guys know what you can edit. In the white space, this is the whole area that you have that I would recommend that you have as editable space. Why do I say that? Because in gray is kind of like the amount of space that you shouldn't have any pictures or any text or any video on there because that's where your comments show up. So I'm sure you guys have all been on a live or you've even hosted your own live and you see that in that area, it shows who's joined your live and it gives the audience and space to leave comments, to add emojis, whatever they want. So that's why I recommend not editing that part basically. This here, this black area is where your video actually moves up when you leave the template completely open. So once you go live, you have two options. You can either leave the template open and have your video up here, or if you just click on your video when this is like the normal setting, you click on this and then it alternates. So your video becomes this white space and your design moves into this black space. So into that black outline. So let's say that I'm creating a live on, I see here that we have Earth Day. So let's say I'm creating a live on an Earth Day event that I'm doing. So I'm going to add a text by going on the left-hand side text. Canva, if you don't already use it, I love it. I use it for so many things. You have different fonts, titles, so many fun things to use. So let's say I want to use this one right here. So it adds it to my template and I'm going to edit the top part. Earth Day. Then at the bottom part, I'm going to put hosted by Laura. Let's say I'm doing a live on Earth Day. So with this, I can make it big, I can make it small. Let's say I want it small. I would recommend using this space right here. This is free space that is not covered up by anything because remember your video is up here. So Earth Day, let's say that my brand is very natural. You know that our colors are green. So I'm gonna change the font color to green. I'm gonna leave that in black so that it stands out and I can even change this border. Make sure not to move it because if you do move it, then it's going to overlap in your video. But I'm going to just highlight by dragging. So I just drag my mouse and I'm going to change this border to a green color so that it matches. All right. And let's see. I'm going to ungroup this and I'm going to remove the text in the middle that says the live moves up there. And I'm going to add stickers on the earth. So let's see, maybe we can even find an animated one. So animated things you can find under elements and then you go down to stickers. You can click on see all, and then you'll just type in earth. So it looks like we don't have an earth. Oh, this one is an earth that's moving. Awesome. So I can make it smaller, I can make it bigger, whatever I want. I'm gonna put it right here so that it's not covering any of my space. So this is a template that's ready to go. All I have to do is erase this once I'm completely done editing. I'll go ahead and erase this part. Oh, let's see, I think it's still here. Erase this part. And then I'm going to download it. When I have an animated, Canva already tells me that it's a video. If I have more, I want to make sure that I'm downloading my animated one by itself. If I download them all together as a video, Canva will literally grab all your slides and make them a video. And that's not what you want. You want to have your own chance to swipe between them when you're actually doing your live. So I'm going to download only page 2, which is the one that I have my already finished template on, as a video. So go ahead and download, and that saves onto my computer. If I have it on my phone, then I'm ready to go. I can go live right now. If I have it on my desktop, then I need to find a way to transfer it over to my cell phone. I can do this so many ways. So if you have a Mac to iPhone, you can do it by AirDrop. If you have Dropbox, you can do it via Dropbox. If you have Google Drive, do it via Google Drive. If you have an email, you can just email it to yourself, open it on your email, and download it. There's just so many ways. Just be creative. Think of something that you already use. There's no need to download any new platforms just to transfer one thing over to another. If you use WhatsApp, I love using WhatsApp. I think it's super easy to send myself things. So I just open up WhatsApp on my computer and I send it to my phone via WhatsApp. I can do the same thing doing iMessage. There's just so many different things. If I have my files on my computer to my phone, I can also do that. So many options. So I have my template down at the bottom. Let's say that we want to do another one on recipes. So let's say that now I'm doing a live on how to make cookies. So let's add first a sticker on cookies. Let's see if we have anything. I see some here at the bottom. I see this one that's moving, but it's like pixelated. So I'm gonna pick another one. Let's see. And then the rest are pro. So if you don't have a Canva paid account, then don't use the pro ones, but that's fine. You can use any of the free things because Canva does have infinite free options. So I'm just gonna use this free option. So a cookie. And we're going to add text. So this is a recipe. So I wanna make sure that I'm using a font that is super easy to read for all of the people watching. So, cookie recipe. And I can make this bigger. So, there we go. It's a little slow. Cookie recipe. So, moving it just about right so that it's not covering the video or the cookie image that I put. I can ungroup this text here at the top so that I can move this freely. And I'm going to start adding in the ingredients. So obviously I don't know if this is a real recipe, I'm making it up, so don't follow this to make your cookies. 1 cup of milk, 1/2 teaspoon of butter. What else? Cookie mix. And that's it. So I want to make sure that everybody can read it. Here at the top, I can change my font. I can change the size. I can change the color. I can make it bold, italics. I can underline it. I can change it. Let's do left alignment. I can make it in all caps. I can do bullet points, so many things. Just play around with it depending on what live you're doing. And I'm going to change the font, maybe 48. Yeah, I think that looks good. So that's easy enough for anybody on their phone to read and to really get the idea of what they're gonna need for this cookie recipe. So I'm ready to go. I have my template completely designed. I'm going to remove the comments area and I'm going to remove this text so that it's ready for my live. I'm done with this, and this is not any video. It's not animated, it's not moving. So I'm just going to download it as a PNG. So PNG, and I only want my template page number 3. So I click on page 3, done, and download. So I have my 2 templates already saved onto my computer. I'm going to go ahead and transfer them via AirDrop to my cell phone. So let's go ahead and do that. So it's on my downloads and it's the last 2. I go here at the top to AirDrop to my phone, Laura Gomez, and then I should get the notification on my phone. Perfect. So I have it here on my phone. As you can see, I have the cookie recipe, and then at the bottom I have the Earth Day video that I designed. So let's go ahead and go live so that you can see the exact process from start to finish. So I'm on my account. I just swiped left to go live. I'm ready to go live. I click on it. All right. To add my template, I'm just, as you know, going to the bottom right hand corner. Let's start with the Earth Day. All right. So it's all good to go. This is what I mean. I can tap by clicking on the video and then it makes the template smaller and my video bigger. So if I'm doing a selfie mode, I would just turn the camera, hello, and that's it. This is exactly how to use a template, and let's go ahead. Now we're making cookies, so let's make the cookie recipe bigger. It's super easy. Look at how nice it looks. It's really the best way to do an Instagram live and captivate your audience. So there you have it from start to finish on how to use this template. Again, if you have any questions, feel free to leave in the comments down below. I try to answer them between 24 business hours, or you can also reach out to me on my Instagram at @TheLauraGomez. I'm always there. And I would love, love, love to see a picture, a video, whatever it is, of your Instagram live. I might even feature you on my next video because I want other people to see how other industries, other brands are using the template, okay? So I hope this truly helped you. Again, feel free to reach out if you have any questions, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye. Hey you, yeah you, thanks for watching the whole video. If you liked it, go ahead and subscribe or leave a comment below. If you want to find me on Instagram, you can search @TheLauraGomez. Talk to you soon. Bye-bye.